Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the end of a very great event is very close now. It's for me, it's an honor to do this conclusion in which I want to take you through the last few items of this conference. And these are the awarding of two poster prizes, some practical things, and of course, some words of thanks. And let's start with the awarding of two poster prizes. This year, we are awarding the best poster prize of the best poster award already for the 10th time here at Physics at Veldhoven. But also we are introducing a new poster prize, and that focuses on science communication. And I would like to ask the chair of the poster of this poster prize, the science communication jury, and that is our new Minerva laureate Julia Kramer, to come to the stage and to introduce this prize and to announce the winner. Thank you.
Yeah, thank you. It was really great that there was so much attention for science communication this time at this MEO Physics conference. Together with Dorine Schenk, we looked at the science communication aspects of the posters, and that was very interesting. We looked at how attractive it actually is from a distance. We looked at clear messages, so no mess, and also I want to remind you that the poster is not a book. After that, when we found the most attractive posters, we went to the presentations of the poster presenters, and we looked at the enthusiasm, but also how much they used the poster in explaining their work. And we were also very happy to see that so many of you used creative extras while presenting the posters. So we made a top three for the posters. So there are three posters nominated. First of all, this poster, which is finding the mechanically stable states of prismatic architected materials. And that was really nice because he brought the 3D materials and also let us play with it. So that was, and the poster is also very nice. This poster of someone who's very dedicated, she was there both days, mobility edge wave functions in charge density waves. And she brought a lot of extras to explain her work. And also the twist and bend poster, which was very attractive from a distance and used metaphors to explain the research. So the winner is... Oh, this is a summary. Let's build up the tension. And the winner of the Science Communication Poster Prize of this year is Twist and Bend. Congratulations. So this person can now come to the stage. Yes.
Okay, thank you, Julia, and congratulations to the winner. And then I would like to ask come to the stage the chair of the best the chair of the jury of the best poster award, and that is Elisabeth van Hauf, and she can tell something about the prize and announce the winner.
Yeah, thank you. So I had the honor of chairing the Best Poster Award for this year. And so the focus of this prize was more on the scientific content. So what we were looking for was, what was the question that was being asked? So the scientific value in that, how it was answered, and what the results were. And we were also interested in how the poster was being presented. So the enthusiasm, ability to answer questions, and also on the presentation of the poster itself, if the message was clearly presented and easily accessible. So the way that we did the selection was we had a student committee who was made up of the 9 themes at the conference, and they did a pre-selection in their own themes to see which posters stood out. And the selection was then presented to the jury, and we made the final selection, and we picked 3 finalists. And so the 3 posters that were nominated this year were, the first one was Finding yeah, this was actually very interesting. There were 2 independent poster juries, so for the science communication and for the scientific, and we have 2 of the same 3 finalists. So, and this is not, well, first of all, you'll notice that picking posters is not arbitrary, contrary to popular belief. And secondly, that communication and science is a very, very key thing to conveying your results to an audience. So the 3 posters that we found were Finding the Mechanically Stable States of Prismatic Architected Materials, Twist and Bend, which you may recognize. And the 3rd one, this is the different one. So Colloidal Superballs in Spherical Confinement. So these posters stood out in the enthusiasm, in the clear message, and in the nice design of the posters. And so this is the summary of the finalists. Again, we found 2 that were the same as the science communication jury independently. And the winner of the poster prize this year is Twist and Bend.
Okay, thank you, Elisabeth, and congratulations to the winner again. So maybe next year we need only 1 poster prize again, I don't know exactly. Okay, so now I really need a paper, because otherwise I will forget a lot of things. I think we can look back on a great congress. And yeah, it's in fact a 2 days lasting party of the physics in the Netherlands. Full rooms, full workshops, and where else can you have dinner with 2,000 colleagues? It's really amazing. Well, that's why I want to start to say with saying a word of thanks to Koningshof, the convenience to help us with the logistics and being able to deal with such a large amount of people for 1 congress. I also want to thank all the speakers to share their insights, their results and their drive with us. And then, of course, the Physics at Veldhoven Program Committee, thanks for the excellent program. So, Danielle Kraft, André Mieske, Thomas Morgan, Jeroen van Ooyen, Anouk Rijs, Daniel van Makelberg, Anna de Visser en Harold Zandvlies, thank you a lot. And as always, last but not least, a lot of thanks to the people from NWO who organized this all. Peter Spijker, Marcel Hoek, Warsja Kapoetjan, Margit de Kok, Martine van Harderwijk en Mirjam van Ooyen, you really did an amazing job. And of course, all other colleagues of NWO who also contributed to the organization of this. Especially I want to mention Marcel Hoek, the project leader of this year's meeting. I want to please stand up and I want a big applause for him for him and his team. And of course, we are all already looking forward to next year, and already for your agenda, 22 and 23 January 2019, the next Physics at Veldhoven will be held. You can take your badges home or leave them in the boxes which are near the exit doors. And don't forget to take your brain gadget with you. And maybe it's good to exercise this year, and next year you don't maybe need a workshop anymore to solve the Rubik's Cube. Okay, thank you all for the participation in Physics at Veldhoven, and see you next year.